setting it up. Hey, come on, Ricky. Structure going on for the honeys, you know. This right here is gonna be like a nice pool. I'm having a pool in the hallway, bitch. Pool in the hallway.
What's that for? Hey, what's that for?
What's that for? Yeah. Oh, this is where I hide my dope and dogs and shit. All
right, dog. Oh, look at this room.
Oh, you left me. I got lost. That's how big my house is. This is a theater. It doesn't have any TVs or screens in it yet, but hey, this is some baller shit. Follow me. Hey, this is my posse. Hey,
that's what Ultimate Fighter.
The bald guy, the Mexican.
Hey, don't you
the really smart white
shit,
guy. The really, that's my, he handled my stocks and bonds and shit like that. You know? Come on, man.
Whatever you do, don't sell.
Some shit right here.
Whatever you do.
Shit.
Just buy.
Let me saw this is the bar, the liquor bar.
The liquor bar.
Hey, what kind of drink you want? I mix it up on the bar.
Protein shake.
Protein shake? Got it. Yeah.
Hey, fix your shirt.
I'm gonna miss it. CST, but guys, chopper.
Oh, oh, no, no. I got something nobody else got. A chopper. Check this ride out.
Look at the wheels.
They say it's a whole world.
Yeah, you're fucking sitting high. Oh my god, that's badass right there. Check out the steering wheel.
Air conditioning system.
Hey, but I got my people driving me to get something to eat. You wanna go? See you later.
While many soldiers are lucky enough to live in a large forward operating base called FOBS that have some comforts of home, that was certainly not the case with the 2nd Platoon of Charlie Company. twice during this deployment, my son went 8 weeks without a shower. How many Americans, can we say, have gone 8 weeks without a shower? Back in the winter of 2007, they were so far out there that I went 8 weeks without a letter, without a phone call, or any emails. On two other occasions, I went for over a month with no contact. This was not because Jeff did not want to contact me. It was because they were only allowed 1 7-minute satellite phone call a month, and Jeff gave his minutes to the married soldiers that he was with. I only mention these things so that you understand that these soldiers spent 15 long, hard, difficult months in some of the most remote, dangerous areas of the mountains of Afghanistan. They didn't complain, they just did their job. Now, you're going to see what we did for them when they returned home. Fort Bragg has gone through a dramatic building phase in recent years. Back in 2005, when Jeff returned from his first deployment to Iraq, his company was told that the Army was building new barracks for them. This did not happen. 15 months ago, when Charlie Company left the very barracks that they returned to on April 13th, 2008, they were told that the Army would build new barracks for them while they were gone. That did not happen. The photos that you're watching now are photos of the barracks that these men have to live in. I was told that these barracks were built in 1942. I have no way of confirming that. Let me begin by saying that I took the photos that you're watching, and I took them on the first two floors of Jeff's barracks on the day after he arrived from Afghanistan. The instant you walk through the front door, you know you're entering a building that should be condemned. The stairwells were filthy dirty. The railings are rusting. When you walk into the first floor and look at ceiling tiles, there's a number of missing ceiling tiles, and there's big areas of mold all over the end of this hallway. It only takes you a few minutes when you start to look to see the mold that's there. The picture you're watching now is a photo of a drinking fountain on the first floor hallway. This is not in a back room. It's in the main hallway for the barracks. The drinking fountain has long since been removed, but you can see the drain pipe on the right side is a large drain pipe and a drain coming off of it that has Kleenex stuffed in it so that the sewer gas does not come back into the building. All of the drinking fountains had been removed from this barracks. Here's a different one where the rags that were stuffed in the drain have been pulled out and sewer gas is coming into the building. Keep in mind, soldiers are sleeping right across the hall from where these old drinking fountains were. Now, the pictures you're watching now and the sequence of pictures that you're going to watch are those that I took in the communal bathroom that these soldiers have to go to the bathroom and have to take their showers. The pictures speak for themselves. The dark spot behind the peeled paint is mold. This is right over the head of where the soldiers stand when they take their showers. Now, these photos were taken out in the area where the soldiers shave and have to go to the bathroom. Look at the ceiling. If you look close, you can see where your paint is rusting off. This is lead-based paint. Look at the ceiling here. Look at the pipes over the toilets. Again, the ceiling and the pipes. This is right above the urinals. Look at the ceiling where the paint is peeling off, falling down. How healthy is that? Sergeants who live in the barracks, by regulation, are supposed to get a room with a private toilet and 122 square feet of living space. Well, that's not going to happen in these barracks, but this is Jeff's room that he shares with another sergeant. This is their toilet, and these are photos of the floor drain in their one-man shower. Here's Sergeant Korn's toilet. The seat on the toilet is broken in half. Someone in the past has repaired the toilet seat by rebuilding the seat with cardboard and then covering it with black electrical tape. Sergeant Korn said that he has to be careful when he uses it because the cardboard section always slides off to one side. And here's a photo of Sergeant Korn's shower curtain. Here's a blurry photo, but it's a picture of the door lock that the room door to the hallway for Sergeant Korn's room has to close with. Now, you tell me if you would want to keep valuable things behind this lock mechanism. This is a photo that Jeff took the morning of April 14th. The second floor toilets have overflowed and there is over 3 inches of water on the floor. I don't need to tell you what the brown water around the floor drain is. There are times when sewage water backs up into the sinks in the lower floors of these barracks. The soldiers have to tell one another who's taking a shower when they turn the sinks on, or the person taking the shower gets scalded with hot water. So the week before this soldier's photo was taken, he was in a war zone in Afghanistan. And less than 12 hours after arriving in America, he was doing this. I don't know about you, but this is embarrassing. It's disgusting. It makes me mad as hell. If these buildings were in any city in America and were called apartments or dormitories, they'd be condemned. The Army's talking about giving soldiers who live in barracks like this another $145 a month. Would you live here for $145 a month? The Army has a program called BAH. This is basically a basic housing allowance that's paid to soldiers who live off base in private homes or apartments. The Army needs to be paying every soldier that lives in these barracks BAH until they can move back into the new barracks that have been promised to Charlie Company for the last 3 years.